Sure. Do you want to use your own computer?
No. So, for the project, I managed to for the story begins the beginning of the semester that I chose to make a drone for the robotic class project. But I finally, after I have that thought, I realized it's really hard to envision the different parameter for the different parts. Like this arm can be longer, the blades can be bigger, and the motor can be smaller. And the controller can be faster or slower, and those kind of question is not trivial. That if you have a certain desire or a certain need, but for this system, for that's why they call it evaluation, because you need to evaluate the model to test if it's controllable, is it stable, and does all the parameter match your needs. So. Today I'm going to talk about some basic back information about the drone. How does it work? How is everything comes apart? And about the modeling and how I model every part and how the model works. So an analysis to show a few figures that I compare with the different parameters to show how different the system can act. If the parameter for the drone is set a bit differently. And I'll have some conclusion. So the background is, so it can be really complicated because like you can make, for say if you want to put a small camera down here, you can put it here, you can put it here. But like put it here, you will have a lower center of mass, and the drone is not that easy to balance, and it's hard to, because you have a, for this point, for this lower point, you have a shorter pivot point, so you have you need a larger torque to give the acceleration for the object. So that's why we need the software to do the complicated math for us, because imagine if you want to add some part for the drone, that if you want to change the model for the camera, you can just swap the parts in the simulation and then change it with another model of your camera that can. So the system basically does the to. a circle. I make two. So the input is two sinusoidal wave that is 90 degrees apart. So that is a circle to plot. So lines up. Get your flies to the radius of the circle. Start to run into a circle. So with this software, I can really, really know how well I can control the system, how well the circle is. So yeah. So for the conclusion, I actually put the PID controller parameter into this drone. I'm still calibrating the controller, but the range of the P, KP, and KI, KD shouldn't be varied that much because the system is pretty accurate. And another step I can do in the future is sensor noise implementation, because all the sensor has noise, and then the Damola just measure the angle between two frames. That can be really, really accurate. But in reality, we don't have that perfect readings. So I might incorporate some white noise and Coleman filter even to the system to make the system more realistic. So another thing I can do for this is for the simulation is add emission control and the path planning for the power consumptions. So for in the future one day, I can just give the drone in the simulation a command to go there and go back. The system will analyze the situation and say, oh, you don't have enough power in your battery to do this. So and if we do have enough battery for us to do this, the mission planner will just plan a whole mission to lift up in some altitude, and it will fly and which height is the sweet spot that you don't have any obstacles down there, and it will fly to the destination and